नमस्ते हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम जेवियन डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ शलाके तंत्र, फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज द नेजल पॉलिप। सो व्हाट आर द नेजल पॉलिप? नेजल पॉलिप आर नॉन नियोप्लास्टिक मासेस ऑफ इडेमेटस नेजल और साइनस मेकोसा। दे आर डिवाइडेड इंटू टू मेन वेराइटीज, द बायलेटरल इथमोइडल पॉलिप and entroquernal polyp. First, we will discuss the bilateral ethmoidal polyp, the etiology. The etiology of nasal polyp is very complex and not well understood. They may arise in inflammatory conditions of nasal mucosa, like in rhinosinusitis, and they may arise in the disorders of ciliary motility or abnormal composition of nasal mucosa, as in case of cystic fibrosis. And various diseases associated with the formation of nasal polyp are chronic rhinosinusitis. The polyp are seen in chronic rhinosinusitis of both allergic and non-allergic origin. The non-allergic rhinitis with eosinophilia syndrome, the NEARS, is a form of chronic rhinitis associated with polyp. And next disease is asthma. 7% of the patient with asthma of atopic or non-atopic origin show nasal polyp. Next is aspirin tolerance. 36% of the patient with aspirin intolerance may show polyp. Sentus triad consists of nasal polyp, asthma, and aspirin intolerance. Next disease is cystic fibrosis. 20% of the patient with cystic fibrosis form polyp. It is due to abnormal mucus. Next disease is allergic fungal sinusitis. Almost all cases of fungal sinusitis form the nasal polyp. Next disease is Kartgener syndrome. This consists of bronchiectasis sinusitis, situs inversus, and ciliary dyskinesis. Next disease is Young syndrome. It consists of cyanopulmonary disease and azoospermia. Next disease is Churg-Strauss syndrome. It consists of asthma, fever, eosinophilia, vasculitis, and granuloma. Next disease is nasal mastocytosis. It consists of chronic rhinitis in which nasal mucosa is infiltrated with mast cells but few eosinophils. Skin tests for allergy and IgE levels are normal. Then pathogenesis of bilateral ethmoidal polyp. The nasal mucosa, particularly in the region of middle meatus and turbinate, becomes edematous due to collection of extracellular fluid causing polypoidal change. Polyps which are sessile in the beginning become pedunculated due to gravity and excessive sneezing. Then pathology of the bilateral ethmoidal polyp. In early stages, surface of nasal polyp is covered by ciliated columnar epithelium like that of normal nasal mucosa, but later it undergoes a metaplastic change to transitional and squamous type on exposure to atmospheric irritation. Submucosa shows large intercellular spaces filled with serous fluid. There is also infiltration with eosinophils and round cells. Next is the site of origin of the bilateral ethmoidal polyp. Multiple polyp, nasal polyp, always arises from the lateral wall of nose, usually from the middle meatus. Common sites are uncinate process, bulla ethmoidalis, ostea of sinuses, medial surface, and edge of middle turbinate. Allergic nasal polyp almost never arise from the septum or the floor of nose. Next are the symptoms of the bilateral ethmoidal polyp. Symptoms of multiple polyp can occur at any age but are mostly seen in adults. Nasal stuffiness lead to total nasal obstruction may be the presenting symptom. The partial or total loss of sense of smell. Next symptom is a headache due to associated sinusitis. Next symptom is a sneezing and watery nasal discharge due to associated allergy. Next symptom is the mass protruding from the nostril. What are the signs of the bilateral ethmoidal polyp? On anterior rhinoscopy, Polypapyrus smooth, glistening, grape-like masses, often pale in color. They may be sessile or pedunculated, insensitive to probing, and do not bleed on touch. Often, they are multiple and bilateral. Long-standing cases present with broadening of nose and increased intercanthal distance. A polyp can be protrude from the nostril and appear pink and vascular, simulating neoplasm. Nasal cavity may show purulent discharge due to associated sinusitis. Probing of a solitary ethmoidal polyp may be necessary to differentiate it from hypertrophy of the turbinate or cystic middle turbinate. Next is the diagnosis of the bilateral ethmoidal polyp. Diagnosis can be easily made on clinical examination. Computed tomography, in short CT scan of the paranasal sinuses, is essential to exclude the bony erosion and expansion suggestive of neoplasia. Simple nasal polyp may sometimes be associated with malignancy underneath, especially in people above 40 years, and this must be excluded by histological examination of the suspected tissue. CT scan also helps to plan surgery. Then comes the treatment of the bilateral ethmoidal polyp. The treatment can be conservative or surgical. First, we'll discuss the conservative treatment. Early polypoidal changes with edematous mucosa may revert to normal with antihistaminics and control of allergy. A short course of steroids may prove useful in case of people who cannot tolerate antihistaminics and or in those with asthma and polypoidal nasal mucosa. They may also be used to prevent recurrence after surgery. Contraindications to use of steroids are hypertension, peptic ulcer, diabetes, pregnancy, and tuberculosis should be excluded. Then the surgical treatment. Patient can undergo polypectomy. One or two polyps which are pedunculated can be removed with snare. Multiple and sessile polyp requires special forceps. Second surgery is the intranasal ethmoidectomy. When polyp are multiple and sessile, they require uncapping of the ethmoidal air cells by intranasal route, a procedure called the intranasal ethmoidectomy. Third surgical procedure is the extranasal ethmoidectomy. This is indicated when polyp recur after intranasal procedures and surgical landmarks are ill-defined due to previous surgery. Approach is through the medial wall of the orbit by an external incision medial to middle canthus. Next surgical procedure is transantral ethmoidectomy. This is indicated when infection and polypoidal changes are also seen in the maxillary antrum. In this case, antrum is opened by Calvin-Luke approach and ethmoid air cells approach through the medial wall of the antrum. This procedure is also superseded by endoscopic sinus surgery. Next surgical procedure is the endoscopic sinus surgery. These days, ethmoidal polyp are removed by endoscopic sinus surgery, which is more popularly called the functional endoscopic sinus surgery, or in short, FES. It is done with various endoscopes of 0 degree, 30 degree, and 70 degree angulation. Polyp can be removed more accurately when ethmoid cells are removed and drainage and ventilation provided to the other involved sinuses such as maxillary, sphenoidal, or frontal sinus. There is an image of a polyp protruding from the left nostril in a patient with bilateral ethmoidal polyp. So here completes our nasal polyp part 1. In next session, we will discuss the nasal polyp part 2. In that, we will discuss the second type of polyp. Okay, thank you so much. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you so much.